Hi everyone, this is Norma with All My Crochet, and today I wanted to share with you a yarn haul from Dollar Tree. Yes, Dollar Tree got some new yarns in, and I went with my daughter the other day, and she spotted the yarn, and she's like, Mom, come over here, you're going to be so excited. And I saw the yarn, and my mouth just fell. I love when Dollar Tree gets the yarn in. I just love it. I know some people have been finding the fettuccine again because I did get some last time and I bought a whole bunch of different colors. But today I found this. They have a whole bunch of colors. So let me show you what I picked up. So this is from Premier and it's called Just Yarn. And it's worsted weight yarn. And it is a size number 4 and you get 131 yards. And it's 100% acrylic. So I picked up 4 of them in white right here. And I picked up the blue colors. So there's 4 in blue. And look how pretty that is. Okay. Then I picked up 4 of them in black. That's the black. Very nice. So I like mixing and matching colors when I'm making the dresses sometimes for the dolls. This is red. And this red is a very nice, vibrant, bright red. So this will make a perfect Christmas dress for the American Girl doll. And here we have pink. So this is a nice pink right here. It's a light pale pink. I don't know if it has a color. It just says pink. But it's a light pale type of pink. Very pretty. So I picked up those. I have other colors, so let me bring that out. So these are the other colors that I picked up. I picked up 4 in the gray, and I picked up some orange right here. This orange is a very nice bright orange too. I like the orange. It's nice because this, since it's around Thanksgiving and Halloween, you can make pumpkins. Now I made this pumpkin right here. Not this yarn. I didn't use this yarn, but it's perfect because look, you got the green for the stem right here, and then you got the orange. So you can easily make some pumpkins for the holidays, for Thanksgiving, or you know, for the season, for the fall season. And so I got the orange. I really like that. I think I'm making more pumpkins soon. And then I got the green here. I got 9 of the green. It's the only one that I got 9 because my daughter wants me to make her a hat and she wants it with this color. So I have to check with her to see if she wants it to be chunky or she just wants it with the one strand. And if she wants it chunky, then you can put 2 strands together and it makes it a nice little chunky hat. So I'm not sure how many it's going to take. Even if it takes like 3 or 4 of them, it's like $4 to make a hat. Not a big deal. So that's what I made with that. But I did want to share one other item that I made. I made these mittens right here. Now, this is not from the Dollar Tree, obviously, the yarn. I think I got this on clearance at Joann. Recently, and it's just a really big mitten, and it is a little big on me, but that's okay because I'm gonna put on like those stretchy gloves, then put this on, and it's perfect. So I made these gloves here with some yarn. I think this yarn was a chunky size number 6, so it's half double crochet. There's a lot of tutorials on YouTube. All I did was did a half double crochet from the top. I started off with 8 half double crochets in a magic circle. Then in the second row, I increased in every stitch to have 16. So once I had 16, then I just did half double crochet in a spiral all the way around. And then when I got to this part of the thumb, the opening, because you got to do an opening, I did the half double crochet. And then I did a chain 3, skip 3 stitches, and then did the half double crochet again. So it gives you that little opening right here for the thumb. And then I continued to do the half double crochets all the way till the end here. The last row, I just did a single crochet at the bottom. And then the thumb part, because you'll have a big opening for your thumb, otherwise it'll be a fingerless mitten. And if that's what you like, that's fine. But for the thumb, all I did was in that opening, I put 9 single crochets. I did single crochets. I put 9 single crochets all into that opening and then just did, I don't know if it was one, maybe 4 rows. And you have to measure it on your hand because everybody's hand is different. So I did 4 rows of single crochet with 9 stitches all the way around in a spiral. And then I decreased for 2 rows to form that thumb part right here. So I did a, you know, decrease in every stitch for 2 rows until I got the thumb there. But it was a fairly easy to, you know, glove or mitten to make. And I really like it. I live in Chicago, in the Chicagoland area. And last winter we had like 50 below zero. And it was just so cold. So these will definitely come in handy. So anyway, this is all the yarn. I did remember that I brought some other crafting items from the Dollar Tree, so I'll bring that out as well. So these are the other crafty items that I found at the Dollar Tree. As you know, they got a new craft aisle. Although I have to say, I usually go to about 4 different Dollar Trees. One Dollar Tree that is the closest to me, literally like 3 blocks from me, is a total disaster. They have nowhere near any of kind of craft aisle because everything is just a huge mess. I think one day I'm going to do a video to show you guys exactly how much of a mess that Dollar Tree is. It's unbelievable. They have none of this stuff. So I found these at couple of the other Dollar Trees. My daughter did buy me a few stuff. She bought me this stuff right here on the side. So let's start with that. This is the scrap knife set. Well, the scrappy, I guess, knife set. And as you can see, look at the letters. It's printed all crooked. But again, it's from the Dollar Tree. So let's see how these blades work. Hopefully they work good. And you get all these different blades and the tool for the blade. So she got me that one. Then my daughter got this. This is the embossing stylus. It's got that little ballpoint here and that right there. So this is good for making different paper crafts. I use this type of tool when I made some roses. And I do have a tutorial in my playlist on how to make some roses. And I used a tool similar to this. Not this one, but that's what you can use this tool for. It's just different kind of paper crafts and stuff. And then she also got me this piercing and scoring tool right here. So you score with this end, and then here's the piercing. Two of them here are for piercing. So she got me those. And then she also got me these clamps. So these you can use for just different things. There's a set of 6 of them. Comes in handy. So she got me that. And then I found some of this stuff here. So this is a glue and residue eraser. Again, look at the printing. It's all crooked, but again, it's from the Dollar Tree. So I got that. And I also picked up these detailing scissors because I collect scissors. I love scissors. These are nice and small, so you can, you know, fussy cut all those little things. So I got 3 of them. I already started using one, so I just got 3 for $1 each. I just got extras. And then this is the chalk writer marker. So you can use that for your chalkboard items. I did pick up this chalkboard right here. I figured this would be nice. And when I went to the Dollar Tree, they only had 2 left. So my daughter picked up one and I picked up this one. So I figured I could use it next summer for the craft show. Hopefully I'll find some more by then. I got that. And I found this. It says pop dot tape, but I opened it and there is no pop dot on any of these that I saw. So it's like 3 different widths. So let me just take this out because I opened it and I was looking at it. I can get it out. So let's start with the thickest one here. So as you can see, it's just thick. So it's just like foam tape, but it's thick foam tape. I don't see any kind of dot. It's double-sided, obviously, foam tape, but I see no dots on here at all. Nothing. It's just straight, which is fine because you can use this for card making. If you want something dimensional, you can use this. So they give you different widths. So this is the next one. This one is obviously not as thick, and it's thinner. And then this is the next one here, and this is a thinner one as well. So you can see and there's no dots on it. So I don't know why they say pop dot tape, but you get three of them. So I picked up two packages of these. And then I found all these pom-poms. Let me get this out of the way. I don't know if you guys have seen these pom-poms, but I love these pom-poms. I found this. So you can attach this to your purse or to a zipper or anything. Or I was actually thinking of using this for a hat. So I don't know, because it's not like a true pom-pom. Can't tell what this feels like, if it's plasticky inside or what. Obviously, if you use this on a crocheted hat, you wouldn't be able to wash it in the washing machine. You'd have to hand wash it. But I'm not sure how I will do that. Of course, I'd have to cut this keychain part off. But I thought that was really, really cute. So I picked up two of these colors right here. I'm definitely might put one on my purse because I really love that. And I picked the blue colors. And then I picked up the pink. And then these are unicorn. So I don't know how this would look like on a kid's hat. Might look really cute. Again, it's a pom-pom, but I'm not sure what is inside, because this obviously is fur, but I'm not sure what it's wrapped, the fur is wrapped in there. But I might try putting one on a hat, see how it looks. We'll see. So I picked up these three colors in them. Pink right here. So that's it for today, guys. This is my haul from Dollar Tree. I was super excited to see the yarn and all this new crafting stuff. Hopefully they will come out with more stuff. Hopefully they'll come out with more yarn soon. So check out your Dollar Trees, see if they have any yarn at yours. So that's it for today, guys. Please make sure you subscribe to my channel. Very important, because when you subscribe to my channel and watch my videos, you know, that's good for me, and I can do more videos and do more tutorials. It's important to, you know, to have subscribers on YouTube, because if your subscribers go down, you know how that goes. So anyways, I want to make sure you guys are subscribing. I know you guys are watching my videos. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit that notification button. And please like my videos. So that's it for today. I hope you guys have a great day. And thank you for watching. Bye.